Hello friends, welcome to Exam Tricks. Today we are going to learn a trick to remember the name of G20 countries. G20 is a group of 20 countries which was formed in 1999. It includes both developed and developing countries. Finance ministers and central bankers of these countries meet every year and discuss on important issues. This year it is being held in Turkey. Turkey is the chair and China will chair in 2016. To remember the name of these countries, as there are 20 countries, the easiest way is to learn the countries using map. Since it is a group of 20 developing countries as well as developed countries, I will try to divide the countries according to the continents, which will make it more easy. Countries are Canada, USA, Mexico. These are in North America. Then Brazil and Argentina. South America. South Africa in African continent. Italy, Germany, France. Europe. Turkey and Saudi Arabia. Middle East or West Asia, Indonesia and Australia. Australia in itself is a continent country. Indonesia is an island country. But these are located side by side and in the southernmost tip. Then Japan and South Korea in the Pacific. India and China in Asia. And Russia more in Eurasia, you can call it. It lies both in Asia and Europe. EU itself is a group. And then United Kingdom. I will show these countries on map, which will make more easy for you. Since pictorial memory is the best memory, if you want to remember something for a longer period of time, remember it through images. In the G20 countries, we have Canada, United States, Mexico. Three countries in North American continent. Then Brazil and Argentina in South America, two countries. In Africa, South Africa. Then here we have Indonesia and Australia. Look, a circle is forming from here to here to here. Then Japan and South Korea, then China and India. Since in the Asia, only China and India are the developing countries. Then Russia. Here we come to EU countries and moving ahead, it is UK here, Italy, Germany and France. These all are Western countries. And in the Middle East, we have Turkey and Saudi Arabia. If in this way you will locate the countries on a map, you will be able to remember these countries for a longer period of time. Look, I can see the country's name without even looking at the names, just by looking at the maps. It will also help you in solving the questions if it comes any map-based question in your exam. Another way of remembering these countries is finding subgroups. In these 20 countries, there are subgroups also. For example, there are P5 countries. What are P5? These are nothing but the 5 permanent members of United Nations Security Council. These are USA, UK, France, Russia and China. EU is itself a group. Then IPSA is there. IPSA is a group of 3 countries, India, Brazil and South Africa, 3 developing countries of 3 different continents. In this grouping, you can also remember two more countries. Which two countries? Indonesia and Argentina. Look, in South American continent, we have seen that there are only two countries, Brazil and Argentina, and these two countries are neighbor also. So if you learn through IPSA that Brazil is in G20, you can easily remember Argentina too. Another way is, in the IPSA acronym, A can refer to Argentina too. But remember that Argentina is not a part of IPSA. Only India, Brazil and South Africa are the three countries in IPSA grouping. Again, in this IPSA grouping, India, through the name India, you can also remember Indonesia, as IND would refer to India and IND to Indonesia. But these two countries, again I am saying, making it clear that Indonesia and Argentina are not part of IPSA. Just a way of remembering. Then axis powers are there, though it is not relevant anymore, but the axis powers were in World War II, who fought against Allied powers, and these were Germany, Italy and Japan. These three countries. These were ravaged in World War II, and then they built their economy again. So they are most probably between a stage of developed and developing nation. Then Australia, obviously it is a continent country, it would be there in G20. And in the Middle East countries, only two countries are there, Saudi Arabia and Turkey. Look, I have not provided any acronym or I have not made any sentence out of these countries. Because if you will make sentence of these countries using first letter or two letters, in the exam, you will definitely confuse, because you will not be able to remember whether A refers to Australia or Austria. So, I would recommend to remember the name of the countries through the map. Make a cycle, just like this. I will again revise it. Three countries, Canada, USA, Mexico. Then two countries, Brazil, Argentina, in South America. Then South Africa. Then Australia, Indonesia, Japan, South Korea, Russia, India, China will be there. Then EU countries, UK, France, Germany, Italy and Turkey, Saudi Arabia. In this way, you can remember the name of G20 countries. If you want to have an acronym for or a simpler trick for G20 countries, there is a trick made by our team in Hindi. Since I have been getting requests to make a trick in English, that's why I have made this video. I hope you like this video and please give me your comments or feedback as well. And don't forget to like the video if you really like this video. And thanks for watching.